sample space. It is denoted by capital S or omega. It is a Greek lid. Okay. Each element of the sample space is called sample point. The number of elements in the set S is denoted by NS. Students, in last lecture, we have discussed some examples. For example, throwing a die. When you throw a die, there are 6 possible outcomes. Okay. And what is a sample space? The set of all possible outcomes of a random experiment is called sample space. Suppose if you want to write sample space for throwing a die, how will you write? See, when you're throwing a die, there are 6 outcomes. Okay, let us write that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, these are all possible outcomes. Yes, now I'm writing this possible outcomes in terms of set. Okay, now this set is nothing but the sample space. This set should be written in a capital letter. Yes, okay. So sample space is nothing but the all possible outcomes of a random experiment. Okay. Now, each element of the sample space is called sample point. How many elements are there here? 6 elements are there. Okay. So each element of the sample space is called as sample point. And number of elements of the sample space are denoted by NS, small n, capital S. Okay, how many elements are there here? 6. So I will write number of elements of sample space of this sample space are 6. Okay, now if NS is finite, then sample space is said to be finite sample space. What do you mean by this? See, look here, when you are throwing a die, I'm just giving one example for throwing a die. When you are throwing a die, how many possible outcomes are there? 6. Yes, only 6 possible outcomes are there. Yes, it is a limited numbers, right? It is, we can't say it is unlimited. It is a limited. So in that case, we can say that sample space for this random experiment is a finite sample space. Suppose if I want to write sample space for the natural numbers are never ending numbers, right? They are keep on going, right? So in that case, you can say that sample space is an infinite sample space. I think students, you must have understood. Okay, let us go to the next slide. Okay, here some examples of random experiments are given. We will see this, how to write sample space of this random experiment and how to write number of sample points in S. Okay, let us take first example. One coin is tossed. One coin is tossed. Now, when coin is tossed, there are 2 possible outcomes. Head or tail, right? Only 2 possible outcomes are there. So you will write these 2 possible outcomes in terms of curly bracket. See, students, when you are writing sample space for any random experiment, you should write in curly bracket itself. Otherwise, your answer will be considered as a wrong answer. Understood, student? You can't write in any type of the bracket. You should write the sample space in which set? Curly bracket only. Understood? Okay. So here, 2 possible outcomes are there, head and tail. So write capital S is equal to in curly bracket head and tail, right? So how many sample points are there? How many elements are there? 2. So sample points are coming as NS is equal to 2, right? Okay. Let us move to the second example. 2 coins are tossed. See, look here. When you are tossing one coin, there are 2 outcomes, that is head or tail, right? But when you are tossing 2 coins together, Okay, what will happen then? Then how many possible outcomes will be there? See, in that case, when you are tossing two coins together, in that case, there may be chances two head will come together or two tail will come together or there will be combination of head or tail. Yes or no? So how many possible outcomes will come? Four. Head, head or tail, tail or head, tail or tail, head. Understood, students? So you should write these possible outcomes in curly bracket. Capital S is equal to, in curly bracket, you will write these four possible outcomes. So how many sample points are there or how many elements are there? Four. So you will write NS is equal to four. Okay, students? Okay. Let us move to the third example. Three coins are tossed. Students, when you are tossing three coins together, again, there are chances that on the upper face, all head will only appear, or tail will only appear, or there will be combination of head or tail, or maybe tail will come in the middle, or head will come in the middle, or head will come front on the front coin, or tail will come on the front coin, like that. So let us see this, which are the different possible outcomes when you are tossing three coins together. Let us see this. See, look here. Either head will come or tail will come. See, look here. Either head will come or tail will come, or tail will come at the last coin, or tail will come in the middle, or tail will come in on the upper coin, or head will come on the upper coin, like that. Like this, different combinations are possible when you are tossing three coins together. How many these possible outcomes are there? Yes, students, eight. Just count this, then you will come to know very properly. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. So total there are eight elements of the sample space. So you will write sample points as eight. Okay, students. Now let us move to the next example. A die is thrown. Now, students, you are knowing when you are throwing a die, there are six possible outcomes. Why? Because there are six faces for the die, and on each face there are different number of dots. Dots varies from 1 to 6. Face may contain 1 dot or 2 dot or 3 dot or 4, 5 or 6. So how many total possible outcomes? 6. So you will write all possible outcomes in sample space. Yes, students. Now, how many sample points or elements are there of the sample space? 6, right? So I will write here, number of sample points of the sample space are 6. Okay, student. Okay, now let us move to the next example. Two dice are thrown means what? You are taking two die simultaneously and you are throwing. When you are taking two die simultaneously and throwing at once, then you can see two dice are thrown. Okay, now you know when you are throwing one die, how many possible outcomes are there? 6. Means the face may contain 1 dot or 2 dot or 3 dot or 4 or 5 or 6. Just imagine you are thrown a one die. When you are throwing a one die, on the upper face, 1 dot may appear or 2 dot may appear. See, look here. When you are throwing only single die, yes, then what will happen? On the upper face, there are chances 1 dot may appear, or 2 dot may appear, or 3 dot may appear, or 4 dot or 5 dot or 6 dot may appear. Now, For time being, let us consider on the upper face. On the upper face, there is a number 1 or 1 dot. Okay. But when you are throwing same die for the second time, it is possible that same dot will appear. Yes, it is possible that same dot will appear. That is, one dot will appear, or two dots will appear, or three dots will appear, or four, or five, or six. Students, are you understanding? Yes, when I am throwing a die first time, I'm just consider first time, first dot or one dot will appear. Okay, and when same die when I'm throwing for the second time, it is possible that one dot only appear, or may two dots may appear, or three dots may appear, or four dots may appear, or four or five or six dots may appear. Okay, so these are the possible outcomes. Okay, this is the first case. Now I'm imagining or considering when I'm throwing a die for the first time, two dots are appear on the first time. When I'm throwing a die for the first time, two dots are appear on the upper face. Okay, now same die I'm throwing for the second time. Then when I'm throwing a die for the second time, there are chances that, or it is possible that one dot or two dot or three dot or four or five or six dot may appear on the upper face. Yes, means again there are again six chances are there. Means for the number one, there are six chances. For the number two, there are six chances. Similarly, I'm taking dots three. When I'm throwing a die for the first time on the upper face, three dots may appear. Okay, same die when I am throwing for the second time, it is possible that dots may vary from 1 to 6. Yes, so again for the number 3, there are again 6 possibilities. Similarly for the number 4, similarly for the number 5, and for the number 6. So total there are 36 possible outcomes, right? If you count all these, see if you count for the number 1, there are 6, number 2, there are 6, for number 3, there are 6, for number 4, number 5, number 6, there are 6 outcomes respectively. So in all, there are total possible outcomes are 36. Okay, so all these possible outcomes you will write in terms of curly bracket, and that is nothing but the sample space. Okay, so what you will write here? Sample elements. Yes, how many sample elements are there? 36. So you will say the 36 sample points are there, and you will write this NS is equal to 36. Okay, now let us move to the next example. A card is drawn from the pack bearing numbers from 1 to 25. So how many cards are there? How many cards are there? 25. Means how many total possible outcomes are there? 25. So you will write all possible outcomes in terms of curly bracket. Right? So you will write this. Now how many elements are there total? 25. So how many sample points will be there? 25. So you will write here sample points are 25. Okay. Now let us move to the next example. A card is drawn from a well-shuffled pack of 52 playing cards. Now students, in the last lecture, we have studied in a well-shuffled pack of playing cards, there are total 52 cards, right? And there are four types of cards are there. Yes, students. And again each type there are 13 cards are there. Yes students, we have studied this very nicely in the last lecture. Yes students. Okay, now which are the four types of card? Heart card, diamond card, these are red cards, 26 red cards. Which are the black cards? 26 black cards, club card and spade card. Okay, now just we'll talk about the red cards. In red cards there are 13 heart cards and 13 diamond cards. Okay, now heart cards are of heart shape and diamond cards are of diamond shape, but they are of red color, right? Now again, now we will just talk about red cards. In heart cards there are 13 cards, right? In 13 cards there are 3 face cards and remaining 10 are the peep cards. Similarly, diamond cards also, there are 3 face cards and 10 peep cards. Face cards means what? King, queen and jack. Similarly, if we talk about the spade card and club card, there are, in each type, there are 3 face cards and 10 peep cards. Okay, so total, in 4 types of card, there are 12 face cards and 40 peep cards. Right, now let us talk about the diamond cards. See, look here, in diamond card, there are total how many cards? 13 cards. Yes, jack, queen, king, that is 3 are the face cards and remaining 10 are the peep cards, that is egg, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yes, students. Similarly, if you take the example of spade card, similarly, there are 13 cards, 3 face cards and 10 peep cards. Same is the case of heart cards also and club cards also. Everywhere in each 4 types there are 13 cards, and in each 13 cards there are 3 face cards and 10 are the peep cards. So in all, when you count together, all are the 52, means sample points of this sample space are 52. Yes students, I think you must have understood very nicely. Let us move to the next slide. Let's remember, the sample space for a coin tossed twice is same as that of the 2 coins tossed simultaneously. The same is true for 3 coins. See, in exam, question may be of the type, 2 coins tossed simultaneously or 2 coins tossed twice. Sample space for both the cases are same only. Similarly, if coin is tossed thrice, is same as that of 3 coins tossed simultaneously. Sample space for 3 coins tossed simultaneously or sample space for 3 coins tossed thrice is same. Understood? Only wordings are different. Otherwise, sample space is remaining same. Okay, now let us move to the next line. The sample space for a die rolled twice is same as 2 dice rolled simultaneously. Same. Yes. A die rolled twice is same as 2 dice rolled simultaneously. Okay, in exam, the examiner wants to confuse the students. So they may give like this. So don't get confused. Sample space for both the cases are same only. Okay. Now let us move to the next slide. Now let us start with the practice set 5.2. For each of the following experiments, write sample space as and number of sample points. Now, first example given is 1 coin and 1 die are thrown simultaneously. Now, students, here See, one coin and one die are thrown simultaneously. Now you know for the coin how many possible outcomes are there? Head and tail. For one die, when you are throwing a one die, how many possible outcomes are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Now, when one coin and one die are throwing simultaneously, how will you write sample space? What you do? First of all, take head, combine with the all three outcomes. What will you write? Head 1, head 2, head 3, head 4, head 5, head 6. Okay. This is nothing but this. You will write like this. Then you will take tail. Okay. And you will combine with all these possible outcomes, that is head, tail 1, tail 2, tail 3, tail 4, tail 5, tail 6. Right? Understood, students? So now, total how many possible outcomes are there? 12. If you count, these outcomes are 12. So you will write sample points are NS is equal to 12. Okay, students. Now let us move to this second example. Two digits are formed using digits 2, 3, and 5 without repeating a digit. Now, which digits we are going to use? 2, 3, and 5. Now, first of all, we will write sample space for these digits. But what is condition given over here? Two digits are formed. These numbers are given, and from these numbers, we have to form two digit numbers. But condition given is the without repeating a digit. A digit should not get repeated. Means 22, means 22, 33, 55, such digits should not be there. Okay, this is the condition. So let us first of all form two digit numbers. Okay, first of all, take first number 2. 2 combines with the 3, what is form? Which digit form? Which number will form? 23. Then 2 will combine with the 5, which digit will form? 25. Okay, now let us take 3. 3 will combine with the 2, what will form? 32. 3 will combine with the 5, what will form? 35. Yes. Now, let us take number 5. Okay. 5 will combine with the 2, what will form? 52. 5 will combine with the 3, what will form? 53. Yes. Now, just count the number of outcomes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, right? These are all possible outcomes when you are taking number 2, 3, 5 and forming two digit numbers. And condition given is without repetition of the digits. Okay, so these are the possible outcomes. Now I will write this in terms of curly bracket. Okay, so I will write all these possible outcomes in form of set in terms of curly bracket, and I am giving name as capital S, and this is nothing but the sample space, right? Okay, so we have counted how many elements are there in the sample space? 6. So I will write sample elements of this sample space are 6. I think, students, you have understood. We will go to the next slide. Okay. The arrow is rotated and it stops randomly on the disk. Find out on which color it may stop. See, student, such particular type of problem is come in board exam for the 1 marks. So you can see the picture of the disk, and on this disk there are different colors. There are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 types of colors are shown. And you can see here arrow is shown. Yes, arrow is shown. And this arrow is rotated and it stops randomly. It is not given that it will stop on particular color only, right? When it rotates, it stops randomly anywhere on the any color, right? Now, what we have to find out? Find out on which color it may stop. See, students, on the disk there are 6 colors, and condition given over here is this arrow will stop anywhere randomly on the any color. Since there are six color, there are six possible outcomes that arrow will stop anywhere on any color, right? So what you will write? There are total six colors on the disc. So your sample space will include six colors, these six colors, red, orange, yellow, blue, green, and purple, right? So how many elements are there in this sample space? Six. So you will write number of samples point of this sample space are six. So now just read this, find out on which color it may stop. So you will write last line as, therefore arrow may stop on any one of the six colors. Yes, arrow will stop any one of these colors. Means for all these six colors, there are equal possibilities. It may stop on the red color, arrow may stop on orange color or yellow color or blue color or green color or purple color. Okay, so last line you will write, the arrow may stop on any one of the six colors. Okay, now let us move to the next slide. In the month of March 2019, find the days on which the date is a multiple of 5. See the given page of the calendar. Such particular problem also carries 1 mark in board exam. Picture will be given, and by observing this picture, you have to answer. Now, what has been asked in this particular problem? In the month of March 2019, find the days on which the date is multiple of 5. What we have to find out? The days on which date is multiple of 5. So let us find out the days on which date is a multiple of 5. Yes, means we will see the numbers which are there in the table of 5. Yes, means 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, like that. Okay, let us see these numbers are where, exactly on which days these dates are coming. Yes, just see this 5, then 10, then 15, 15, then 20, and lastly 25. Okay, 30 also there, 30. Okay, count this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, 6 days are there. But what they have told, find the days. We want to write the number of days on that particular date. On the date 5, which day is there? Tuesday. Yes, on the date 15, which day is there? Friday. On 10, there is a Sunday. Then on 20th, Wednesday. On 30th Sunday, on 25th Monday, like that. Okay, so total if we count, how many days are there in this sample space? 6 days are there. So number of sample points will be 6. So you will write this, NS is equal to 6. Before that, you will write in sample space all these possible outcomes which are multiple of 5. Okay, dates which are multiple of 5. So you have to correlate this dates with the days, and you have to write this in a sample space. Okay, lastly, what you will write? The days on which the date will be multiple of 5 are Tuesday, Sunday, Friday, Wednesday, Monday, and Saturday. Okay. So, this type of sums are or problems are very easy. Only you have to observe the given picture and you have to answer. Let us move to the next slide. Form a road safety committee of two, from two boys, B1, B2, and two girls, G1, G2. Complete the following activity to write the sample space. Okay, here what is given? This particular problem is given in the form of activity. Blanks are provided. So if there is some rough work, you don't write there itself. You have to write rough work on the rough pitch. Here you have to directly write in the blanks. Understood? Okay. Now what you have to form? You have to form road committee, road safety committee of two, from two boys and two girls. Okay. So committee of two boys, what will come? B1, B2. Right. Now committee of two girls, what will come? G1, G2. Understood? Now committee of one boy and one girl, what will come? See, just combine with this. See, B1, B2. B1 will go with the G1, that is B1, G1. B1 will go with G2. You will write B1, G2. Then combine B2. B2 with the G1. B2, G1. And B2 with G2. B2 with G2. Understood? So when you are forming committee of one boy and one girl, there are four possible outcomes. Now, what is the last activity? Sample space. Sample space means what? You have to write all possible outcomes. Yes. When you are taking committee of only boys, this outcome will come. When you are taking committee of only girls, this outcome will come. And when you are taking combination of boys and girls, these four outcomes will come. So total there are six outcomes, because in sample space you are writing all possible outcomes, right? So all these outcomes you will write in a sample space. Okay, let us move to the next slide. See, so committee of two boys, that is B1, B2. Committee of two girls, G1, G2. Committee of one boy and one girl, these four outcomes. And sample space means all four outcomes, all six outcomes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Six outcome will be there in the sample space. That is all possible outcomes. Okay. Now, let us move to the next slide. Now we'll learn next concept, that is event. Okay, students, what do you mean by event? The outcomes satisfying particular condition. The outcomes satisfying particular condition are called favorable outcomes. A set of favorable outcomes of a given sample space is an event. And event is a subset of sample space. Students, see, I'm just giving one example for throwing a die. For throwing a die, there are six possible outcomes, right? I'm just writing this, all six possible outcomes in terms of sample space. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. These are all possible outcomes for a random experiment like throwing a die. So I have written this in terms of the sample space. Now what I want? Now I want my favorable outcomes. Now which are my favorable outcomes? If I say I want on the upper face only even numbers. So which are the even numbers? 2, 4, 6. Okay, now let us write this, my favorable outcomes, separately. Now this, my favorable outcomes, I write in terms of the set. And this set is nothing but the event. This set is nothing but the event. Means the set of favorable outcome is called as the event. An event is generally denoted by capital letters A, B, C, D. Here I am denoting these my favorable outcomes, set of my favorable outcomes as event A. Yes, students, are you understanding? See, which example I have taken for throwing a die? For throwing a die, how many possible outcomes are there? Six possible outcomes are there. I have written in terms of the sample space. Okay. Now I'm just considered my favorable outcomes are even numbers. Now, which are the even numbers? 2, 4, 6. Now, this my favorable outcomes I have written in terms of the curly bracket. Okay. Like as in terms of set. Okay. So, set of favorable outcome is nothing but the event. Set of favorable outcome is nothing but the event. And events are generally denoted by the letters capital A or capital B or capital C and capital D. Here I have denoted this event as A. So I will write event A is equal to in curly bracket 2, 4, 6. Yes, students. So how will you define event? The outcome satisfying particular condition is called favorable outcome. See, this is a sample space which these events satisfying which condition? It satisfies that my favorable outcomes are even number. Yes, and that's why I written this in terms of events. All favorable outcomes I will write in terms of set, and this set is nothing but the event. Yes, students, let us take one more example. Two coins are tossed. Now, when you are tossing two coins together, there are total how many possible outcomes? Either head will come or tail will come, or there will be combination of head and tail. Means total four outcomes, possible outcomes will be there that you are going to write in a sample space, right? Now, see, what is the event? A is the event of getting at least one tail. Means what is my favorable or desired outcome? Yes, getting at least one tail. At least one tail means if the tail is more than one, then also it is okay. Right? Now, first of all, let us write sample space. Head or tail or head tail or tail head. Now, what is my favorable outcome? Getting at least one tail. At least one tail means if there are two tails, then also it is okay. Okay? A is the event of getting at least one tail. Means this will come. If more than one tail is there, then also okay. If one tail also there, then also okay. Okay, but if two heads are there, then it is not okay. So these are my favorable outcomes. Yes, these are my favorable outcomes. These I will write in terms of event A. Yes, that is tail head or head tail. Okay, now if you count how many number of sample points are there in a event A, or how many elements are there in the event A, then you will write, see, this is what is the set name A. Okay, so you are writing NA, that is number of sample points of the event A are 3. Yes, students. So today you learnt what is the event. Yes, students. Event means what? The set containing favorable outcomes is an event. Now let us move to the next slide. See, we will see now types of the event. Certain event or sure event or impossible event or simple or elementary event, complement of event, mutually exclusive events, and exhaustive event. Students, this is I'm giving just for your knowledge. This is not part of your syllabus. In the textbook, only these names are given, not extra information about these events are given. But let us discuss this by one by one. Let us first of all concentrate on first type, that is a certain event or sure event. Now, what do you mean by certain or sure event? An event which contains all the sample points of the sample space is called certain event. The sample space is a certain event. See, look here. this I want to explain you by means of one example. For example, if I say I'm throwing a die, okay, when I'm throwing a die, how many possible outcomes are there? 6. So in sample space, what I will write? In sample space, what I will write? I will write all possible outcomes from 1 to 6. Yes? Okay. Now, suppose I will say A is the event that on the upper face, there are all natural numbers. Yes? What is my favorable outcomes? That on the upper face, there are all natural numbers. Now, if you see here, sample space from number 1 to 6, all are natural numbers. So, in this set, favorable outcomes are all this. So, I will write everything. 1, 2, 6, 5 and 6. Means sample space, this event contains all the sample points of sample space, right? And in this case, I can say this event as a sure event or certain event. When event contains all the sample points of the sample space, in that case, you can say that the event called is a sure event or certain event. Okay. Now, let us move to the next type, that is an impossible event. Impossible event is also called as a null event, or you can say empty event. Okay. An event which does not contain any sample point or sample element of the sample space, it is called impossible event. See, impossible event means what? Null event. Now, again, I'm taking this example only for throwing a die. For throwing a die, how many possible outcomes are there? 6. So, I have written in terms of sample space. Now, suppose if I say my favorable outcome is a number greater than 6. So what I will write in the event, let us say that A be the event of getting the number greater than 7 on the upper face. So let us write that. See, what is my favorable outcome? The upper face contain number greater than 6. So just see in this sample space, the number which is greater than 6 is not there. So what will come here? Nothing will come. Yes, means this event does not contain any element of the sample space. And in this case, this event is called as the impossible event or null event. Students, are you understanding? Yes, students, I'm just taking one more example. Suppose if I say, I want my favorable outcome as multiple of 5. Multiple of 5, but more than 10. I want my favorable outcome is multiple of 5, but more than 10. Then also, while writing the event, I will not write anything in the set, because the number which is multiple of 5 and more than 10 is not available in this sample space. And in that case, I will not write anything in this sample space. So in that case, this, such type of event is also called as an impossible event or null event. Okay. Now let us move to the next type, that is simple or elementary event. An event consisting of only one sample point of the sample space is called simple or elementary event. Now, again, I'm taking the same example for throwing a die. So, sample space will contain all 6 possible outcomes. Suppose I am saying A is the event of getting number 1 on the upper face. So what I will write in the event A? 1. Why? Because my favorable outcome is only number 1. So I will write only number one in the event A. So how many sample points are there in event A? Only one. And so it is called as an elementary event or simple event. Okay. Now let us move to the next type, that is a complement of event. Now what is a complement of event? Let A be the sample space, the set of all the sample space which are in S but in A, which are in S but not in A is called complement of event A. Now again I am taking the example of throwing a die. Okay, I have written sample space of throwing a die, means I have written all possible outcomes. Now let A be the event that the upper face contain all even numbers. So all even numbers means my favorable outcomes are 2, 4, 6. So A be the event of getting even number on the upper face. Now what is the complement of A? How will I write complement of event? See, just see number 2, 4, 6, which are there in a set A or event A, which are not there? 1, 3 and 5. They will come in complement of A. Means the elements which are there in the event A but not there in event A are complement of event A. Are you understanding, students? See, look here. Let A be the event of the sample space. The set of all those sample points which are in S but not in A. See, look here. In A, which elements are not there? 1, 3, 5. Okay? See, in the A, which elements are not there? 1, 3, 5, which will come in A dash or complement of A. Okay? The elements which are there in S but not in A are coming as A dash. Okay? Let us move to the next type, that is mutually exclusive events. Now, let us consider S be the sample space of throwing a die. Yes? And A and B are the events of S. Let us consider event A and event B. Now let us consider A be the event of getting even number on the upper face. So 2, 4, 6 will come, right? And let us consider B is the event of getting odd number on the upper face. So I will write 1, 3, 5. Now just see. How many elements are common in both these events, A and B? Nothing is common, right? The event A and event B do not have any common elements. And in this case, such events are called mutually exclusive events. In this case, such events are called as mutually exclusive events. Now let us move to the last type, that is exhaustive event. Now, what is an exhaustive event? Two or more events are said to be exhaustive events if their union is a sample space. See, again, I'm taking this example of same events. Suppose A be the event of getting even number on the upper face and B be the event of getting odd numbers on the upper face. Now, students, if you join together all these sample points together, you will get sample spot. You will get sample space. Means the sample space is nothing but the union of event A and B. Yes or no? 2, 4, 6, you look here. 1, 3, 5. 1, 3, 5 is there. 2, 4, 6 is there. Means the sample space is union of event A and B. So in such case, These events A and B are called exhaustive event. Yes, students, I think you must have understood this. Students, we will continue in the next lecture. Thank you, students.
Hello, Rohini ma'am.
Yes. I'm leaving
yeah,
now.
Thank you so much. Yeah, thank you so much.